can move on to GCC. And really, assuming GCC installs okay and the tests are reasonable, then there's really not much else can go wrong. I think I did encounter one more. Was it one or a couple more errors? But they're minor things, and if they crop up again, I'll just show you what I did to fix those errors or work around them, as the case may be. Okay, so that's built successfully, so I'm going to run the test now. And we'll see what we get, and that's finished. Okay, so that test has finished. There were some errors. So let's just take a look to see if there was anything in particular. I do remember getting errors, a number of errors when I was testing this. So it's quite possible that they're going to be the same with any luck anyway. But I'd be happy just to carry on and say I've tested this and it does work. So I'll just take a quick look. It's got 3 under G++. Well, that's quite a few under GCC. Yeah, there's quite a few. It could be to do with the cross-compiling, it could be other issues, but as I say, I've done this before, and although the end result wasn't perfect, it did work, and as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I would advise, for the reasons I mentioned there, to build Linux from scratch on top of this on the native system once you've built the cross-compiled system. So let's carry on and finish the installation. Ordinarily, with that number of errors, I would be inclined to go back maybe to the tools part and start again due to the quantity of errors. But in this situation, I think it'd be safe to carry on. So that's GCC's built. So really from here, I shouldn't get too many problems. As I said, there's one or two that do, well, I did get when I was testing, but we can go through those anyway when we meet them. So let's get rid of the build directory and the package directory.